prebiotics. Prebiotics are substrates that are selectively utilized by host microorganisms to confer a benefit to our health. Take note of the word selectively utilized. To qualify as a prebiotic, a particular substance must only affect a specific group of microorganisms rather than the entire microbial ecosystem. And so we need a lot of research to support that. Some fibers that meet the criteria for prebiotics include things like fructooligosaccharides, galactooligosaccharides, inulin, and resistant starch. These fibers are all really important in helping to fuel specific populations of bacteria in the gut, like bifidobacteria. Most people don't get enough fiber in the diet, which means they don't get enough prebiotics. And so really, when we're talking about working with patients, we want to focus on bridging the fiber gap to get closer to 25 to 38 grams a day to ensure people are getting adequate prebiotic fibers. Some examples of those things include onion, garlic, whole grains, and pulses, which can really up intake of prebiotic fibers in the diet. What are fermented foods? Fermented foods are often confused with probiotics, but they're actually really different. Fermented foods are foods or beverages that are made via controlled microbial growth and enzymatic conversions of major and minor food components. So what we mean by that is microbes might be involved in preparing the food, but not all fermented foods have microbes that last the whole process or the right amounts to qualify as a probiotic. So fermentation is often really focused on enhancing flavor, texture, and also preserving food. Some fermented foods can qualify as probiotics, but not all fermented foods are probiotics. Probiotics specifically are live microorganisms, when administered in adequate amounts, infer a benefit to our health. People often ask me if probiotics colonize the gut. I like to think of them as visitors. So they're actually transient according to current research. So you ingest them, they come in and they do their job, and then they leave. They don't stick around forever, which means that in terms of taking them, it's something that needs to be taken regularly to see a specific benefit.